The film was mainly shot in England, and there were extensive scenes in countryside because, you know, Lawrence wrote very much about the elements of air and earth and fire and water, and the novel really captures all of these qualities. And Ken Russell, I think, was the perfect director to recreate that in a movie. So there were many scenes in the forest, and some of those we did day for night with the house in the background. And again, I used this 3N5 filter, shot it as the daylight was getting low, and put tungsten lights in the house behind so that you had the yellowy quality of tungsten and the blue-green of the day for night quality. And there were other scenes that we did in the forest where he's just had an argument with Alan Bates has had an argument with his then lover, played by Eleanor Bron, and she's hit him with a paperweight, and he runs away, and there's blood streaming down his head, and he runs away from the house into the forest, and it's a forest of birch trees. And so we had these beautiful birch trees, which were ideal for day for night, because when you do day for night, because everything's much darker, you need contrast. If you don't have contrast within the scene, you know, you finish up with just an area of dark gray. So you need tones of light and dark. And usually when one does day for night, you do it in sunlight so that the sunlight looks like moonlight and you get the contrast. Well, as it happened, when we shot this, it was an overcast day. So we shot in this forest and with overcast light. And again, I used the 3N5 filter. And because there was so much contrast between dark trees and the silver birch, and Alan Bates had all this blood streaming down his face, and he was wearing a white shirt, it was a very convincing day for night look. There was another scene where he lies in a field of long grass, and I wanted the feeling of early morning dew. And so we sprayed the whole of the area with water so that it was like dewdrops on this very tall grass about 3 feet high. And then I backlit it with a brute to bring out the globules of water so that they sparkled. And he lies down in this grass and he kind of cleanses himself with the glass, with the wet grass, and wipes off all the blood from his face and his body. And it's a kind of cleansing moment. And he's using this grass and water to kind of clear his mind of this woman that he wants to get away from. And it's this kind of getting close to nature, which is so apparent in the film.